Good afternoon to all my dear students. This is our computer lecture and it is for standard 3. So today we'll start our the first lesson from the standard 3 and our topic is what is a computer. This is our the first lesson in the our computer textbook. In the third standard we learn about what is a computer and then part of the computer. So let's start our lecture. Before starting the lecture, I am saying that I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Wash your hand continuously and cover your mask also, and stay away if anyone have a fevers or anything. So let's start our the lecture. So in this lecture, what we learn today? The first that we learn today is about a computer. The definition of computer, what is a computer, and the meaning of the computer. Now the second point, that the uses of computer. What are uses of computer? The second point we learn in this lecture is uses of computer, and also at how the works a computer. Now the third point, see this third point, the part of the computer in the detail. Different part a computer have, that you know already in the standard 1st and standard 2, but in the standard 3 we will learn briefly in detail in this lecture. So these three points in this lecture we learn today, so you have to make note also. Okay, in this lecture, the first computer lecture, in the first lesson, these three points we learn in this lecture. So starting from the first point, the what is a computer. See in the side, right hand side, I am showing this the computer and their part. This is a monitor, this is a keyboard, this is a mouse, CPU box and speaker, and the one remaining is the printer. These all are the part of the computer, as you know, in the standard 1st and standard 2nd. So now the definition of computer. What a computer is? A machine. What I am writing here, a computer is a machine. But which kind of machine? Computer. A computer is an electronic machine. Which kind of machine? Electronic machine. Because why we call them electronic machine? Because all the machine have electricity use. Without electricity, a machine cannot work. At the same, the computer is also machine, and without electricity, computer cannot start. So we call them the electronic machine, right? Now, it used to write, draw, do sums, play games, listen to music, and watch cartoon films and the movies. That the main uses I am writing here just now. I will explain that. Used to write, what it means, used to write. In the textbook we use a pen or notebook to write anything, for example our exercise, our lesson, whatever the teachers give a homework, they all things we write in our notebook, right? So we can write also in the computer with the help of the keyboard. The keyboard is the one device of computer, right? And it is used to write. We can write letters, numbers, special symbols, whatever you just want to write in our computer, you can write. The second point is to draw. It means we have draw anything in computer. For example, we use a drawing book to draw. Yes, at the same, the computer have some software that help us to draw anything in our computer. Do sums, it means calculation, mathematics, sums, subtraction, division, multiplication, this all kind of mathematic calculation we can do in our computer also. To play a games, you know that, I think you all are playing in the game at your home if you have a computer. Now second is the listen to music. We can listen to music in our mobile phone, in our TV, in our speakers, right? As well as we can listen the music in the computer also. And to watch a cartoon films and the movies, it is the same, we watch the movies and the cartoon films in the TV, right? For same as the computer, we can do it in a computer also. So these all are the uses of computer and the definition of computer. What is first is, a computer is a machine. I am saying the computer is a machine and it is used to write, draw, do sums, play music, games, watch cartoon films and movies. So these are the first point we learn in this lecture. Now the second slide. how its work, how computer works. The first is, its work very fast, right? You know that if we are writing in our notebook, that it so take a time. But we write in a computer with the help of a keyboard, with the help of our hand, so it make our work very fast. Yes, yes, definitely it work very fast. Now it doesn't make mistakes. What I am writing, it does not make mistakes, which means we have in writing in notebook, so we use eraser if any mistakes are done. So it is possible whenever I am writing also I make a mistake, but in computer if we are doing anything, then computer does not make mistakes. Now the third point, it makes our work very easy, right? We can do anything quickly in our computer. So I am writing that it makes our work very easy because it is a machine and it helps us to make our life easy. It can remember many things. What I am saying that it can remember many things. For example, I have to remember so many things. For example, my exam paper, my lessons also. So it is difficult to me to remember at a time all things. But in the computer, they can remember all that thing that we do in our computer. So computer make our work very fast, does not make mistake, and remember many things. Now the second, it can not get tired even if it work for a long time, which means, for example, we have a school and we continuously take a lecture without any break. So we get tired. Yes, we get tired. No, but in computer it doesn't get tired. If we started my computer in the first lecture, I am continuously working in the fourth lecture also, that so computer cannot get tired. And the last one, it can do big calculation very fast. We have a mathematical sums, a large number of value, then we can do it in computer very fast and easily. So I am mention here 6 points, that is the main uses and how it's work the computer. You can understood clearly. So now can we move to the next slide, the part of the computer, which here, the first I am showing is monitor, second CPU, third keyboard, fourth mouse, fifth printer, and the sixth speaker. These six part are the main part of the computer. See, this picture, I am take this picture from your third standard textbook, and this is a monitor. See my arrow moving on the monitor. This is our monitor. This is a keyboard. This is a mouse. This is the CPU box, and this is the speaker, and the last one, this is a printer. I know you all are aware of this part because you go in the computer lab and do typing and drawing in our computer lab. So now move to the next one. See this picture? It is a monitor. What? It is a monitor picture. It looks like a TV screen. How monitor look like TV screen? See here, it is the same as a TV. Yes, and it is also a computer. So monitor look like a TV screen. And what it shows? It shows whatever you type using a keyboard. What? It shows whatever you type using the keyboard. Keyboard is used to write. Yes, and monitor, it shows whatever using the type using the keyboard. So I am writing my name Shweta from the keyboard, then the Shweta spelling is display on the monitor screen, and also shows whatever you draw using the mouse. What? Also shows whatever you drawing using the mouse. With the help of the mouse, we can draw flower and weather also, tree also, fruit also, whatever you want to draw, any shape you can draw using the mouse, and it will display on shows on the monitor screen. So this is the first part of the computer, the monitor. You can understand the monitor. Now the next part, which picture is? It is a CPU box, right? It is a CPU box and the main part of the computer. The CPU is the main part of the computer, and it control all work of our computer. What? It control all work of the computer, which means without the CPU box, first of all, computer cannot work. Yes, without the CPU box, computer cannot do any performance in our computer. So CPU is the main part of the computer, and it control all the work of the computer. It means we are writing, we are doing sums, we are watch movie, we are drawing, we are do anything in our computer, they control by this CPU. They control by this CPU. So CPU is the main part and control all the work of the computer. And the keyboard, mouse, speaker, printer, this all part of the computer connected to the CPU. What I am saying, this all the part, keyboard, mouse, speaker, printer, this all the part of the computer connected to the CPU box with the cable wire. For example, we are connecting our TV, so we have to connect this pin to board, switchboard. At the same, we have a mouse cable wire, keyboard cable wire, speaker, printer, these all cable wire are connected to this CPU box. So now you can understand this term also, the CPU box. Now move the part of the computer, the third one, which is, it is a mouse. It shows here, it is the mouse, the smallest device, right? It is a mouse. And a mouse has a two or three button on it. See, here I am moving my cursor. This is the first button, this is the second button, and this one is the third to scroll up and down. So main, we have used two button, left button and the right button. These are the main button of the mouse. So we have a two or three button on the mouse, and it is kept and moved on a mouse pad. What I am saying, it is kept and moved on the mouse pad. You know what is a mouse pad? Whenever we go in the computer lab, you see that the mouse is kept on a one black cover, right? So this black cover, square black cover, is called mouse pad. What? The mouse pad. And you can draw using picture the mouse. You can draw picture using the mouse. What? You can draw a picture using the mouse. You have to hold the mouse and move on a monitor. You can hold the mouse and you can move the mouse. So whatever you draw using this mouse. Now see the holding the mouse. How we hold the mouse? So the first is place your right palm on the mouse. What I am saying, you have to hold with the help of the right hand. You can only use your right hand to hold your mouse. To hold your mouse, you have to put your right hand on the mouse. As this picture shows, this is our right hand and we can hold this right hand. Second is, put your first finger on the left button. Put your first finger on the left button, which means this is our first finger. See here, this is our first finger and this kept on the left button. See here, this is our left button and we can keep it in this. So we can use the right hand for holding the mouse. From the right hand, we use the first finger on the left button. Now second is, put the middle finger on the right button. See, this is our middle finger. You can see this is our middle finger and we can put in the right button. This is our left button and this is our right button. So we use our first finger and middle finger to put on the left button and the right button. First finger put on the left button and the middle finger put on the right button. Now the second point, hold the mouse on the side with your thumb and remaining two fingers. What I am saying, the hold the mouse. The remaining finger we can use to hold the mouse. See here, the thumb is here at the side of the mouse and these two fingers, it also at the side of the mouse. So these are five finger we can use to hold the mouse. The first finger and middle finger, it put on the left button and the right button. So now you can understand how to hold the mouse. Yes, so now move to the next one, the part of the computer. This is a part of the computer. Which one? It is a speaker. Which one? It is a speaker and speaker are used to listen to music. Yes, you know all that the speaker are used to listen to music and speaker are also connected to the CPU device. And speaker have a cable wire and this cable wire is connected to the CPU box. Now see the next part, printer. Which? A printer. See this picture. It is a printer picture, right? And this printer have a white paper also. So what is the work of, what is the use of this printer? To print on a paper. Printer can print all that you write and draw on the computer. For example, we are writing our story. So this story is also printed on paper using this printer device. Using this printer device. And also we can use anything, we can draw anything in our computer. For example, I am drawing the rose. So rose is also printed on this white paper using this printer. And printer is connected to the CPU. What? A printer is also connected to the CPU. Keyboard, mouse, speaker, printer, monitor, these all five parts are connected to the CPU box. Now see the next one. The part of the computer. What? The part of the computer. See, this is a keyboard picture. Which? The keyboard picture. And the keyboard look like a typewriter. You can see this, it have so many buttons on it and it is look like a typewriter, because typewriter is also look like this and typewriter have so many button on it, A to Z letters and special symbols also. So it is the same as the typewriter. And the standard keyboard has an 104 key. What? The standard keyboard has a 104 keys. If you have a computer at your home, laptop, so you have to count that keys, that how many keys on the keyboard. I think that is 104 keys. So you have to count that the how many keys in the keyboard if you have a computer or laptop at your home. And see here, this is so many buttons on it. So this button is called the keys. We can call this button the keys. The keyboard has so many keys, right? These buttons we call that a keys. In the keyboard we have a numbers, we have alphabetic letters, A to Z letters, we have a special keys, a space bar, backspace, that we learn next, and a special symbols also. See here, we can see here this plus sign, underscore, comma, question mark, division, multiplication, subtractions. These all the signs we can see in the this keyboard. Small bracket, square bracket, yes, curly bracket. These all the special symbols we use with the help of the keyboard. Now we can learn about the keyboard keys. So move to the next slide. This is a number key. See this in picture, I am highlighting this from the keyboard. This is from here and this one. This a line. This is from here. These two boxes I am showing here, it is a number key. It is used to type numbers 0 to 9. We have a 0 to 9 numbers on the keyboard at the left hand side and the right hand side that I am showing in this picture, and that have a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 numbers. This 0 to 9 numbers we have in our number keys and it is used to write numbers. So the next one, the letter key. Which one? The letter key. What is the use of the letter key? It is used to write letters and words. What? It is used to write letters and words. So see this picture, I am showing this. They are QWERTY keyboard, Q-U-E-R-T. These are the first letter. These all are alphabetic letter, A to Z letter. You can see this. These are the alphabetic letter, and with the help of this alphabetic letter, we can use, we can write letter, word or anything you just want to write. So this is also called the alphabetic key. What? Letter key is also known as the alphabetic key. So letter key is used to write letters and words. And number key, what is the use of number key? Number key is used to write 0 to 9 number, used to write any numbers that you want to display on the monitor screen. As the number, numbers key, matlab numbers and the letter key, which means letters and words and sentences, whatever you want to write in the computer. Now move to the next key, space bar key. Which one? A space bar key. What is the use of space bar key? It is used to put a space between letter, word and number. What I am writing here, it is used to put a space between letter, word and number. We can use a keyboard for writing letter, numbers, word, yes, special symbols, these all things we can write. But if we have to write my name, for example, I am writing my name Shweta, Shweta. So, and also my writing my surname Yadav. So I have to put a space between my name and my surname. So which key I will use here? A space bar key. Which key? A space bar key. See here, this is a space bar key. I am highlighting this key. This is a space bar key. And it is used to put a space between letter and word and number, right? So you can understand the space bar key and uses of this key. The longest key on the keyboard. The longest key on the keyboard, it is a space bar key. And it is used to put a space between letter, word and number. Now move to the next key, the enter key. Enter key. See this picture? I am showing here the blue color two keys, this one and this one. These two keys are a enter key, which a enter key. And the enter key is used to go to the next line. What I am writing here, it is used to go to the next line. For example, in the first line, I am writing one number. Now, I want to go in the next line. So, which key we used? Which key? Enter key. Enter key is used to go to the next line. We have a two enter key in the keyboard. This one and this one. At the middle of the keyboard and the right hand side of the keyboard. These are the two enter key in our keyboard. And it is used to go to the next line. So, if I am writing a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 line wise. So first I am writing, first I am pressing this one number from here. Now I want to go to the next line. So I am pressing the enter key. For now I am moving to the next line. So I am put as 2. Now again enter key. Now 3. Again enter key. 4. Again enter key. 5. Again enter key. Same sequence to be continued until I am writing the 9 letter. So I am writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These all are a number keys and uses a enter key go to the next line. Now move to the next key. A cursor key. Which one? A cursor key. Which one? Cursor key. You can see this cursor key here. Green color box I am showing here. This is our cursor key. Which one? This is our cursor key. It is used to move a cursor to left, right, up, down on the screen. You can see this arrow, up arrow, down arrow, left arrow and the right arrow. These four arrows shows the different size. Up, down, left, right. So if we move to the upside on the screen, which arrow we will use? This is a up arrow. Which arrow? This is a up arrow. It shows the upside, right? It shows the upside. So it is called the up arrow. Now the next downside. Downside. You can see this here. Here is the downside. You can see this. It shows the downside. So if I am move cursor to the downside on the monitor screen, so you can use this arrow to down, to go to the down. Now see, this is the right arrow. It shows the right side. Yes. So if you want to move to the right side on the monitor screen, so which key we used? This, the right key, right cursor key, right? And this one, the last one, this is a left key. Which one? A left key. So it is used to move a cursor to the left hand side. To left hand side. So these are the all four key, up, down, left, right. a cursor key. Which key? It's called a cursor key. This green color box I am showing here, this is our cursor key. And it is used to move a cursor up, down, right, left. So now you can understand the first key what we learn: number key, then letter key, then space bar, then enter key, and then now the cursor key, the fifth one, right? Now move to the next key, shift key. Which one? The shift key. You can see this, a shift key. See here, this one and this one, these are two shift key. What a two shift key in the keyboard. And what is the use of this shift key? It is used to write in a capital letter. What? It is used to write in a capital letter. Capital letter which means a big letter. A capital letter which means a big letter. You can see this here in the keyboard. It is all letter, A to Z letter are shows in a capital letter, big letter, right? But it doesn't mean ki if I am pressing this A, then monitor can display this A at the same as a keyboard at shows in capital letter. In the monitor, they are written in the small letter, not in the capital letter. So if we want to write this letter in the capital, so we uses this shift key. We uses this shift key. How it's work? Let explain this. First, we have to press this shift key. We can pressing this key and A key. So we can both press the key at a time. So the letter A should be in a capital letter, the display in the capital letter. For example, I am pressing this simple A letter. This A letter, I am simple pressing this A letter. The monitor cannot display in the big letter. They can display in the small letter. But I am pressing the shift key and A key both at same time. Both a same time, I am saying the both a same time. We can press a both a same time. So the capital A should be written in a computer screen, a monitor screen, right? So the shift key is used to type in our capital letter. What? The shift key is used to write in a capital letter. We have a two shift key as the same as the enter key. We have a two enter key and two shift key, right? We have a one space bar key. So now move to the next key. Which next key? Caps lock key. Which one? A caps lock key. See the caps lock key, this here. This one, I am moving my cursor here. This is our caps lock. The spelling is also written in this key. CAPSLOCK, caps lock. We have a one caps lock. See here, I am moving my cursor in this key. This is our caps lock key. And it is used to type in a capital letter. It is the same as a shift key. But the difference is that we have to press the shift key and letter key both at a time. But in the caps lock key, it doesn't work like that. We have just press this key and here the center. You can see this here. The light will be on. If we pressing this caps lock key, here the light will be on. It means the caps lock key is in a on mode. Now if you want any letter type in from the keyboard, so it all are typing in the capital letter. For example, I am pressing S, H, W, E, T, A. So these all letter are should written in a capital letter. What? These all letter are written in a capital letter. So you can understand the difference between a shift key and caps lock. Shift key, we can use the shift key and letter both at a time. We have to press this both key at a time. For example, I should write S in the capital, then use a shift key. So press S, shift key and S both at a time. So the S should be in the capital letter. But whenever we using a caps lock, the caps lock is not like work. We have to just press a caps lock and we write any letter that should be written in the capital letter, right? Now move to the next backspace. See here the blue color I am highlighting, this is our backspace key. The backspace key is a character to the left of the cursor, which means it is from the left side. We have it is a left side letter, so we use is a backspace key. From the left side I am writing my name, so I can erase my name by the left side using the backspace key. Now the next one, the delete key. Which one? The delete key. And the delete key, it is a character to the right of the cursor. What? To the right of the cursor. We have a delete key here. Right? This is the blue color delete key. This is used to erase a character to the right side. What? A right side. From this right side. So, if my cursor is in the center of my name and surname, so my name is from the left side and my surname is from the right side. So, the surname will be erased if I am pressing this delete key. Which this delete key I am pressing, then the right hand side of my surname from the cursor is deleted. So, my surname will be erased by pressing the delete key because it is from the right hand side. So in this lecture what we learn? What is a computer? How it's work? Uses of computer? Part of the computer? And detail in the part of the computer? And also holding the mouse we can learn in this lecture, right? So today's lecture is over. In the next lecture we continue this the keys and their use, and also we can learn exercise. So bye everyone, take care.